Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. Padlet's become very popular over the last year with COVID and lots of teaching online. I've got a couple of videos on Padlet that are very popular. I've been using Padlet since it was called Wallisher more than 10 years ago, and I'm a big fan of the technology. I've made a set of videos that take you through everything: how to make Padlets, how to set up the security, how to get people to comment on them and rate the different Padlets, the different styles of Padlets that you can use. Also, how you can archive your Padlets if you run out of free ones to use, or how you can save them as images. This course goes through everything. It also shows you how to combine Padlet with Zoom or Google Meet or Microsoft Teams. And of course, it also talks about using Padlet in the classroom. So this is a complete training course in Padlet from someone who's been using it for more than 10 years. Really hope it's useful. And as always, please like the video. Please share the video with other teachers. Leave any comments in the section below. And of course, come and join me on teachertrainingvideos.com. Follow my work by signing up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with everything, all the videos and the blogs and the online courses and the webinars I run. Right, let's get started. Okay, we're going to take a look at Padlet. A Padlet is like an electronic cork board where people can kind of add all their ideas up onto the screen. And I'm going to sort of give you an example of what a Padlet looks like. So basically, the idea is that you create a Padlet and then people can, with a link, can access the Padlet and add their ideas onto the screen. So it's, and they're all kind of arranged on the screen like stickies. So if we looked at a quick example, if I clicked on this one, this is really quite an interesting example because it's huge. In fact, a lot of students didn't get to finish. I had quite several hundred people in the session, but people were just putting out what they were going to do once the lockdown was over, because it was at the period of the lockdown. And you can see I just collected everybody's ideas together on the screen. Now, we're not limited when we add a Padlet to just writing on the screen. We can also add video and audio, and I will look at that at the end. But the basic idea is that it's electronic cork board, but there are actually quite a variety of different cork boards. And before we actually look at the process of creating one, because it's very easy, let's just take a quick look at some examples. Way to get an idea of what Padlet can do is to have a quick look at the gallery, and it's worth spending a bit of time here because you really see some nice examples. I can show you this one here. This is just a poll where people have put up different answers. They've included pictures, and then people have voted on the best one, what would be the theme of a senior prom to be. So they were choosing a theme, come up with different ideas, and then people voted on it. Okay, so that's another thing that you'll notice, that people can respond to content that's been added to a Padlet. We can also do timelines with Padlets, and here what we've got is the songs of the year since 2010 from the Grammys. And you can see that each year a different song has been added. This could be writing, this could be video, well, it is video in this case actually, or this could be, for example, images, so you can, or even audio files. So you can do timelines, obviously, with dates. The whole idea of timeline is something that's obviously over a period of time, whether it be something from history or, in this case, obviously the song. So timeline can work really, really well. And then obviously a lot of work can be built around the timeline afterwards. This is a nice one. It's complete ideas, or lots of ideas, lots of suggestions from different people about what you need to do if you're preparing for a half marathon. And people have put up video, they've put up pictures, and they've obviously written text in. So don't forget, all of these are where people have made their individual contributions. Remember that we can just create a Padlet, share it with our students, and then our students can come on and add their content into the Padlet. Been working in groups and writing about memorial days around the world. So again, nice kind of idea, and again something that could easily be done collaboratively. It's really worth looking at the gallery to get some ideas. Let's create a Padlet, and to create a Padlet we need to click on Make a Padlet. Once we've clicked there, you'll notice that there's all different layouts, okay? And again, this can really add a nice element. There's a back channel, so each one comes underneath, okay? You've got like a grid, which is the one that I often use because it lays them out in a kind of grid form. You've got a kind of random one here, a canvas idea. You've got the timeline. You've got a very interesting one here as well, which is where you've got a map. And you can kind of mark different places on the map. This really works well. This one's a shelf, so this can be nice if you put an idea at the top and then you put under contributions connected to that idea underneath, then another idea here, contributions underneath, another idea, contributions underneath. That can work really well. So all these are worth learning because they can all be used for different things. I'm just going to do the simplest one, which probably one of the most simplest, grid. They all work exactly the same way. I'm just going to click on here, and what I'm going to do to begin with is just do a super simple question, and that question is going to be how are you finding teaching online? So let's imagine I want to ask this question to a group of teachers, which is something I've done very often. I click on next and I'm ready. And I can just start posting. And all I need to do now is share that link with my students. Now, obviously that could be via email, that could be added into Edmodo or into Moodle or into Blackboard. Or of course, I could just directly share that link into Zoom. So I'm gonna demonstrate that. So just copy that, okay? So copy. And then I would come back to my Zoom. Now I've minimized my Zoom, I'm just gonna maximize it again. Okay, so just to explain what I normally do, if I'm in a session in Zoom, I will minimize the Zoom, do the Padlet, and then come back to the Zoom by maximizing. And then I simply open up the chat window and paste the link in, and then press the button so that now all the students can just click on that link and go to the Padlet and engage with me. So that's how I use it if I'm using it in an online class. Obviously, sometimes I'm just asking the students to do the Padlet in the evening time for homework. So I might put it into Edmodo or into Moodle or into Blackboard, or of course you could even share it via an email. Simply, you need to get that link to the students. Students need to do is double click on the screen, and especially if they're writing, what I normally get them to do is write their name at the top, and then they can add their comments by just clicking and writing underneath. It's as simple as that. Okay, you do need to click to, you know, to kind of focus on that area, and then you can start writing on the screen. Now you're not limited to only adding up text. You can in theory add all sorts of things, including, if I wanted to, and I'm just going to demonstrate it, uploading a picture that you may have in your Padlets, for example. So if I wanted a I've got a picture here of me, I could add that. Okay, I can turn that off. I think I can get rid of that, yes. But then you've got other options as well. You can link to some content if you want to recommend a website or something. So for example, if I quickly jumped over to my website and I was to link, copy, and then come back and add that in, so it would also work. And you get again a little image when you do that. And another really nice thing you can do with that link is add a YouTube video. Now when you add a YouTube video, the best thing to do is to go to the video, click on share, and copy the link. Okay, then again, I'm going to jump back now to Padlet, click here and paste in that link, and then click on save. Okay, and the same thing happens when you add a video up onto Padlet. You'll see in a minute it will visualize onto the screen as well, and also provide the button. Now in fact, Padlet can do even more, and we're going to look at that in a minute. The next thing I'm going to point out to you, I wouldn't recommend doing this in an online session because the students have already got their microphones connected to Zoom in an online session, but especially for homework, it is also possible. And again, I'm going to double click on the screen, write my name, okay, but this time I'm going to click down here and I'm going to choose the option of voice. And I can just check now that I've got the correct microphone set. So I'm going to actually change it because I'm obviously using one microphone to do this recording. But what I can do is just change it to my webcam. Okay, so I'm using a different microphone. And now I'm going to click on the button here. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, 1, 2, 3. I can click on the pause button and I can then discard and restart or play back and save, which is what I'm going to do. So let's see if that's worked. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing. Absolutely perfectly. I'm going to put a title in, Russell's Ideas, and then I'm going to click on save. And now that is going to be added on to the Padlet. So Padlets are really, really powerful in this way, because we can put all sorts of things onto a Padlet, including video, links, text, pictures, and of course audio. Now if we looked at a Padlet again by double clicking again, I'm just going to put my name in one more time, and then I'm going to click again here and then look at these options, okay? And there are several other ones, including taking an immediate snapshot of yourself if you're sitting in front of a webcam, and look at all these options here. Now in all honesty, the one I've ever used really is voice. Okay, I've not really played around with any of these other ones. There's a draw one, I do believe, and I think that you can sort of draw onto the screen, okay, and then once you've drawn onto the screen, again, you can save that, and that can become a contribution. So it's worth looking at these, but the most interesting one for me certainly is the option to do a speaking activity. One of the most powerful things about Padlet is that we can get our students to respond to the content that other people have put up. So we can have like a first activity where the students add content onto the screen, and then a second activity where they can respond. And in this example, we can see that students have responded by leaving comments on what they think of the different ideas. But there are other ways of doing this, and let me just show you a couple of examples. So for example, in this one, people have been grading the pictures that other people have put up onto the screen. I think this was after a visit to China. So you can see loads of different activities that we can do, but then we can get the students to kind of engage with the content that they've created. And this is really important, and it's something I talk about a lot in the training sessions that I run. Responding to student-generated content, don't just leave it. And it's one of the basic reasons why students begin to lose interest in doing online activities, if they see that the teacher is sort of asking them to do something and then nothing is done with that particular content. Read what other students have done and add your comments onto the screen. And if you notice, I in fact have even more options, because I can click on reactions and I have the chance, if I want, to allow them to like their favorite post, or to vote on their favorite post, or to star their favorite post, or even to grade their favorite post. Now, I haven't used this grade button that often, but I did use it very recently when I got a series of students to write introductory sections to their essays, and to put them up onto Padlet, and then people to grade those based on a criteria. So again, lots of possibilities, but the point I'm trying to make here is that we can actually limit our students to, first of all, doing an activity and putting up their content, but then releasing the comments button so that students can then add comments associated with other pieces of work that other students have added onto the screen. If you're working with students who are younger and you're maybe worried about what they're going to put onto the screen, another useful button when you create a Padlet is to simply click here and to come down and choose require approval. And what that does is it basically means that nothing will be added, don't forget to click on save, nothing will be added onto the Padlet until you have approved it. And I'm going to quickly demonstrate this idea, and I can do that by copying the link, and I'm going to log in as a student. So I'm logged in as a student now, and I'm going to click on the screen and try to add some content. And as you can see, it says, Russ, I'm going to put my name and I'm going to write something, but you'll notice it actually says, you have to click on the screen, it actually says requires approval. And now, even though I think that's been added onto the screen, if we go back and see what the teacher sees, Now you can see that the teacher can decide whether to delete or to approve. If he approves, that will then, or if she approves, that will appear on the screen. And in this case, I'm going to delete it. And then that actually just is wiped away. So that approve button can be really useful. But if you have a free account, you're always limited to three. But there's quite a few things you can do to keep a record of your previous Padlets. The first one is to come up to the share button and to simply choose save as image. Now, if you save that as an image, and it does take a few seconds for this to work, you've then got an image of the Padlet, and of course, then you can delete that Padlet from your collection. So now I've got an image of my Padlet, and of course, what I can do now is just simply save that particular image. And to do that, I could just right click and click on save image as. You'll see that that image is now a PNG file, PNG file, pretty standard file, and you could save that onto your computer. I'm going to add this, for example, into my Google Sites. So I'm on my Google Sites. I'm just giving you an example. You could obviously embed this in many places. I'm going to create a new page on my Google Sites, and I'm going to call it Padlet. Okay, and then click on Done. And then just double click on the screen. I'm going to go to the embed code. I'm going to choose embed. And then I just paste that code in. Click on Next. And that is now inserted into my Google Sites. Now that could be anywhere. That could be in Moodle, that could be in Edmodo, that could be you know, on a website, or on anywhere basically where you want to embed a copy of the Padlet that you've created. Maximum. And when that happens, you'll click on make a Padlet and you'll realize that you can't create one. Now, what can you do about that? Well, one obvious thing to do is that you can archive your Padlet. So if I click here, it is possible for me to take a Padlet and archive it. And then it will be added to my archived. And I can click down here and I can see that I've got three Padlets archived at the moment. So that's one way of reducing the number of Padlets. The obvious thing to do, though, is if you simply click on the Padlet. So let's just go back to one. And then we can simply click up here and turn that. Sorry, clicked on the wrong button there. Click on the share button. Save the image of the Padlet, so you've saved the image, and I've already showed you how to do that. And then of course you can actually delete this Padlet, and then that will again free up space. So if I was now just to close this one, let's imagine that I've saved it as an image, okay, and then I'm just going to come back to my Padlets, and then what I can do is I can actually delete that Padlet. Now, to delete a Padlet, all that you need to do is click, and then you just click on delete Padlet, and you have to put in a code and then click on delete, and that Padlet is deleted. I really hope that video was useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more videos. There's a special section on teaching online and a special section on Zoom. You can sign up to the newsletter if you'd like to keep up with all my latest videos, my latest blogs, my online courses, my webinars. You can sign up to the newsletter here, and you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell to get updated with all the latest videos. And finally, if you want me to do some training for you, then please contact me on the website. Doing lots of work these days around Camtasia and Zoom and Moodle, both in groups and in one-to-one sessions. And thank you very much.